Chapter 9. Rama wins Sita's hand. All arrangements for Janaka's yaga had been completed, and to Mithila had come many rishis and brahmanas from various kingdoms. Vishwamitra and the princes were duly welcomed. Janaka's preceptor, Satananda, was the first to pay honor to Vishwamitra. Janaka followed him. The king said to the sage, "I am indeed blessed that you should attend my yaga." Pointing to Rama and Lakshmana, Janaka asked Vishwamitra, "Who are these god-like youths who resemble each other and carry their weapons with the proud ease of seasoned warriors? Who is the happy father of such sons?" Vishwamitra told Janaka that they were the sons of King Dasharatha. He narrated how they had protected his own yaga and destroyed the Rakshasas. "They have come here," the sage went on, "to see if they may the great bow of Rudra in your palace." Janaka understood the meaning of Vishwamitra's words and rejoiced. The king said, "The prince is welcome to see the bow. If he can string it, he will win the hand of my daughter." Many were the princes who saw this bow and went back, unable even to move it. "I shall indeed be happy if this prince succeeds where so many have failed, and I am thereby enabled to give Sita to him." Janaka then ordered his men to bring the bow, which was kept safe and sacred in an iron box. It was brought on an 8-wheeled carriage and dragged like a temple chariot during a festival. "Here," said Janaka, "is Rudra's bow, worshipped by me and my ancestors. Let Rama see this bow." After obtaining permission from Vishwamitra and the king, Rama stepped out to the iron bow case, while all eyes were fixed on him in wishful expectation. Opening the box, he lifted the bow effortlessly, as if it were a garland of flowers, and resting one end of it against his toe, he bent and strung it and drew the string back with such irresistible force that the mighty bow snapped with a crash like a clap of thunder, and there fell from heaven a shower of flowers. Janaka proclaimed, "My beloved daughter shall be wedded to this prince." Vishwamitra said to Janaka, "Send your swiftest messengers to Ayodhya to give the news to Dasharatha and invite him." Janaka's messengers reached Ayodhya in 3 days. They met King Dasharatha, who was seated like Indra on his throne, and said to him, "Sage Vishwamitra and King Janaka have sent you happy news. Your son who came to Mithila has won our princess Sita by fulfilling the condition set for her hand. He not only strung Rudra's bow, which none before could so much as lift, but bent its tough pride till it broke. King Janaka eagerly awaits your gracious consent for the marriage and your presence and blessing at the festivities. May it please you to start to Mithila with your retinue." Dasharatha, who had sent Rama with Vishwamitra with a heart not altogether free from anxiety, even after the sage's assurance, was thrilled with joy on hearing this good news. He told his ministers to prepare for the journey and left the very next day for Janaka's capital. Dasharatha and his following reached Mithila and were received with enthusiastic welcome. Exchange of courtesies over, Janaka said to Dasharatha, "My yaga will soon be over. I think it best to have the marriage as soon as the yaga is over," and sought his approval. Dasharatha replied, "You are the bride's father, and it is for you to order things as you wish." At the appointed day and hour, giving away the bride, King Janaka said to Rama, "Here is my daughter Sita, who will ever tread with you the path of Dharma. Take her hand in yours. Blessed and devoted, she will ever walk with you like your own shadow. Iyam Sita Mama Suta. Sah dharmachari tava pratichaha chinam badram te panim grihinishva panina. Pativrata mahabhaga chai vanugata sada. This shloka is uttered in every wedding in Upper India when the bride is given away. Thus was Sita given by Janaka to Rama, where they not eternal lovers reunited, and so they rejoiced like lovers come together after separation.